Do you agree with Jesus that this is the command of God?
You got a mic. You got a mic for him as well.
Then why do you break the command of God?
You got a mic for him as well.
Yes.
You had your chance. You told me to be quiet when he was talking.
And I need the most to serve. If you want to spend your holiday, you come back from somewhere.
My friend, you didn't even know the context of this. Let the people who know the context speak, please. With all due respect. So what I'm saying is that, did Jesus remind them this is the command of God? Okay. Why would Jesus remind them this is the command of God if it wasn't even applicable? Thank you very much, guys.
Because of the fact that they're the ones starting off criticism of his disciples, and he's attempting to use one case study example to show that it doesn't.
But I agree with that. We already agree on that.
You agree on that. But what I'm saying is that you're not warranted. It's not explicitly evident. That he's also commanding them to follow that.
You haven't answered my question. Why would Jesus remind them of a command of God which was inapplicable at that time? It doesn't make sense, does it? The only reason somebody will remind you of a command or an edict is because that is still applicable today. The fact that he says this is the command of God, yes, makes it even more strong in the sense that those people are talking about tradition. But Jesus is actually giving them a counter-argument from not only tradition, but something greater than that, which is what?
The command of God. But here's the reason he brings up that specific example is from the context that shows that they weren't following that.
Of course they weren't.
Exactly. That's why he brings up, so if they're following all the commands.
Which is only proving my point.
The point is, imagine you've got 10 commands, and the Pharisees are following 9 out of 10 commands, and they're not following this one command, and that one command is this thing about some children disobeying.
Yes.
Right? Then he's going to highlight that one command that they're not obeying.
Yes.
And that's the point.
So was he expecting them? Was he expecting them to obey this command?
That's the point, we don't know.
That's the question I'm asking you. You seem to have analyzed everything except the question I'm asking you.
I'm answering.
No, I asked you 3 times now.
I am.
What is the point of Jesus reminding them of a command which they were not supposed to follow?
Because that was the one command that they weren't following.
But they expected, based on Jesus, what they expected to follow.
And my answer to that separate question, that specific question, is it is not explicitly evident in the context.
No, but logically, rationally, listen.
It's plausible to infer it, I'll give you that. Yes. But it's not logically necessitated.
Okay. Would it be possible for it not to be a command that is valid?
Yes.
Would it be possible?
Yes.
Then would it be possible at the same time that Jesus is giving them a command which is already void? It's pointless for Jesus to point that out. Think about it. Let me give an analogy. Imagine today we have the traffic law. Yes? One of the traffic laws is that when somebody's crossing on the zebra line, yes, the cars should stop. Well, at least in this country, yeah?
Yes.
Alhamdulillah, in Britain we got most of the people following this command. If the traffic law says that you have to stop, and somebody stops, then they are abiding by the law. But if the traffic law did not have this law, that you have to stop at the traffic law, at the zebra crossing, or at the traffic lights, for example, then would there be any point of a traffic police officer come and remind the person who has crossed the zebra line without stopping when there were people crossing? Yes? Would there be any point? Sorry, attempting to cross. Yes? Would there be any point of him reminding of a command that is not applicable anymore?
Probably not.
No, don't say probably not.
I'll say no.
Now, be sincere.
I'll find it.
Okay, now wait. Why is it not fair analogy?
Okay.
If a command is not applicable anymore, there wouldn't be any point anyone reminding you of that command.
Okay.
Is that right?
Several reasons why the analogy doesn't work. First point was that in your analogy, you're not compensating for the other motivation which we brought up, which is the fact that Jesus is bringing up this command, irrespective of whether it's void or not, because of the fact that it's the command that they're not following.
Now,
right?
Give me the analogy that I gave you. You said the analogy doesn't fit. I want you to give me with the example of the analogy of the traffic law, why it is wrong.
Are you saying people weren't following it anyway?
No, the people were not following it
because
you asked me a question, let me answer.
Yeah.
The people were not following that law because it wasn't applicable anymore.
Yep.
But even then, the police officer comes and reminds them that this is the law which you should follow. You see what I mean?
Yeah.
So if it is not applicable anymore,
amen,
then there is no point of the police officer reminding them of the law which is null and void now.
Okay.
So Jesus telling them that this is the command of God, he didn't say this was the command of God.
Yeah.
Jesus is telling them, why do you break the command of God for the sake of your tradition? You see what I mean? Does it mean? It's not, now it's not possible. Now it is confirmed that this was the law even then during the time of Jesus. Do you agree? No, you're not very convincing there. Do you agree that Jesus
I'm somewhat confused.
Earlier you said it's plausible, it's X, Y, and Z. I'm saying Jesus confirms it.
I'm answering you. Yeah, because of the fact that the Christian understanding of Jesus bringing in the new covenant sort of thing, right? And his not complete abolishment of the old covenant, but his instigation of the new covenant, the Pauline idea, all that kind of stuff, right? For me, I haven't read enough to know, understand exactly when is that officially instigated. Is that during his ministry? Is that after the cross? That's why I'm saying that. That's
okay. We're dealing with this particular example.
The reason why that is exactly relevant is because of the fact that with your analogy, I'm not, maybe you did encapsulate it in your analogy. When we're talking about, you've got to get the idea of a previous law and a new law coming, right? And so when you're just saying this law is void, that doesn't compensate for that we have a new law in place. And the reason why that applies here is because Jesus is pointing out that hypocrisy with this example and showing you're not following this one command. He could be trying to show the fallaciousness and insufficiency of their current way of pretending to follow God, and thereby then bringing, here's now the new covenant which you are to follow. Implicitly, not explicitly, implicitly.
Yeah, but we are not talking about implicit, we are talking about explicit.
I know, but my point...
Do you agree?
I even said to you...
You know, before you finish this particular topic...
The one thing you said beforehand was the fact that it's not explicit. I said this before...
Command is explicit. You can't deny that.
I said it's not explicitly evident that Jesus is saying you have to follow this command.
Jesus is explicitly telling me...
He's reminding them of...
No. Jesus is saying this is a command. You are breaking the command of God. What does it mean?
Yeah.
Breaking the command means what?
They are breaking the command.
Okay, is the command applicable to them?
Yes.
Good. So we got one thing confirmed. The law is there. The command is there. The command is still valid.
And that
bit, wait.
I already said I was being sure about that.
Let me finish. The command, it's not about you being sure, it's what Jesus already confirmed. You are breaking the command of God, which came what, 1400 years from his time.
But he didn't say what you just said.
No. He said you're breaking the command of God, is there?
Yeah, but you just extrapolated that extra.
What did extrapolate from
that? You said that the law is still 100% relevant right now. Right? And I said that he didn't say that at all.
But isn't that inferred already?
Can I just clarify? I think I agree with you, but because I don't know fully about it, when the new covenant and all that kind of stuff is instituted, I don't know.
By the way, the new covenant doesn't mean the old covenant is no more valid.
I know, but I'm saying...
What are we arguing about?
Because of the fact that it doesn't completely invalidate the old law, but there are certain things that you're not to follow from the old covenant. Like the whole forbidden things about eating pork and so on, that's not the same
thing. Okay, so who made it now? Well, I would say legal, or allowed it or permitted it to eat pork. Was it Jesus or Paul?
It was God.
Yeah, but who commanded this? Paul or Jesus?
Paul.
Okay?
It was God. It was God who was talking to Peter in the dream. When he said about the dream.
But Peter, look, did Peter eat pork?
No.
There you go.
If
that was the case, did Paul and the council in Jerusalem, did that already have a disagreement about this particular rules of the law is still applicable for the people who are Jewish or who are within the law? Yes, the dietary law. And then for the Gentiles, it's a different rule. So there was a disagreement already there as to who is allowed to eat pork and who's not allowed to eat pork. So it's not like you say that all of a sudden it was now permitted. Yes, it was kosher for everyone.
But my point is, it's not. I don't know, maybe it is clear, but I haven't looked into it. But I don't know when this new change comes in.
So that is one thing we have clarified. The other thing is about circumcision. Another thing from the time of Abraham. Yes? What is the covenant that God established with Abraham? With regards to circumcision.
In a nutshell, for circumcision as a sign of our covenant between you, that I will continue on your generations for on and on.
A covenant until the end of time. Yes? The end of time hasn't come yet, right? So, was this covenant broken by Paul or not?
No. again, all I'm saying is I don't know enough about this.
As Paul said, I'm sure you've read about this.
I've read about it, but
Paul said, yeah. The circumcision of the heart is important, yeah. Not of the flesh. Yeah. Was Jesus circumcised in the flesh?
Yeah.
I believe so, but it was definitely, you should read the book, it's in the New Testament. Was Abraham circumcised in the flesh?
Yes.
Were his children circumcised in the flesh? Yes. Were all the people of his progeny now had to abide by the covenant of being circumcised in the flesh? So who gave Paul the authority to change this covenant, which according to God Almighty was to last until the end of time?
Again, I said, one, I said I don't know the context of it. Secondly, we're now deeply waiting for TV as a point.
No, it's still about the command of God.
No, because what we were talking about was the fact that I'm saying it's not clear when the new covenant gets instituted, right?
No, Jesus
that's
said,
the only reason I brought that
Jesus
up.
Said anyone who changes even a jot from the command, from the law, is called what? Exactly. Guess who that was? Paul, one of the perfect examples of the early Christians who changed this law, which according to Jesus, even a jot, forget about an entire law like circumcision, which people change, was Paul. And Paul is the one that the Christians today are following, unfortunately, not Jesus Christ. Okay? So anyone who says...
There's
no separate debate, my friend.
It's the only reason I...
You know, when you came into the discussion, we were talking about the law, which was of the Old Testament. That's why you came in the middle of the conversation.
Yeah.
Yes, that's why I'm telling you, I'm still on the same topic. I did not change the topic. The topic is still the same. The command of God, which Jesus was referring to in Matthew 15, was also from Exodus, from the Old Testament.
Yeah.
Yes, and for Jesus to remind it after 1400 years shows that it was still applicable. Now, whether he wanted them, or he wanted to force them, or abide by that is a different matter altogether. The fact that he